In the last video, we changed some elements here to drop-down menus to have an easier access to the information here. And this time, we want to add more subforms here. But before we do that, I have some leftovers from last time. So here it still reads type ID and material ID, and it would be nicer if this would say type and material. So to change this, I switch back to the design mode. Click here on this column and say column, and I have again a title, and I change this to type, and I do the same here for material. There it should read material. Okay, that's fine, I save that. Now the actual content, how can we add more more subforms? And to do this, we have to open the form navigator. This is this little button here. If you don't see this toolbar, you have to go to view toolbars and select form design here, and with that I remove that. You can see now it's gone, and I go again, make this visible. Okay, if we have that, we can directly click on that, and now we can see all the elements that are currently in the form here. And here's our first subform, and we want to add another subform. To do this, I click here on my main form and say new form. Now we have an empty, not existing form that's not here already, but be sure that you have selected form here. And now we want to add a table for our subform, which shows us the actual data. And it is nice if we have already this assistant on, because this will help us in entering or adding the data here. So if this is not highlighted like this, please click on it so that's highlighted. To add another table here, we have to click on further elements on this button here, and here you will find this little guy here. That's the table element, and that's what we like to have. It's the same like we have it here. Again, make sure that this form is selected so that this belongs to this form, and now I click on that and draw here my new table. Release it. Now the assistant starts and asks us this form, which table should it belong to? And I said we want to have the individuals here, so I selected table individuals. And then what fields we would like to see. We don't want to see the ID and the grave ID. We don't need that, but we need these four here, so sex, age, orientation, and completeness. Ready. And now we have already our subform, but we can again change that a bit, like we did it here. So sex ID, this should actually be represent sex. So I change this by replacing this text field. Well, let's have a look how it looks like this. So currently we have a text field here where we just can enter data. We change this by clicking here, saying replace by a list field, and click again and say column, and now we can define the properties of this column. And we did that already in last video, so I change the title here and I say my data should not come from a value list but from an SQL, from a query, and I want to have this here, all the sexes should be displayed, again name and ID. The order is important. Saving, closing. And the same I do for age, so I select here age, right click, replace by list field, and change the title and at the data, I say again SQL query all the ages, name and ID. Saving, closing, ready. To see the effect, we have to enter some sexes and some ages. I will do that now off screen. And now, when I use the drop down, I can see the entries here from sex, age. I have to write a value for orientation and completeness, let's say 50%. And with that, I have connected values here. And when we look to the table of the individuals, here the table of individuals, you can see that our first entry is here. I forgot one thing, grave ID is currently empty. And that's not good, because it's currently not connected here. So to do this, we have switch again to design mode.